Welcome, guys. How are you doing?
Great, thanks.
All right, so you guys are the founders of, what's it called, Rate My Gold, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep.
The founders and creators. That's fantastic. So tell us a little about the app.
Well, basically, Rate My Gold, it brings ratings from RateProfessors.com to gold when you're choosing courses. So it puts a button under each professor name in your course listing page. And when you click that button, it brings a pop-up out. And that pop-up contains all their ratings from the website. So yeah, it just brings it right to gold.
Dang, that is super convenient. Mm-hmm. So is this a brand new thing, or is this something that's been done at other campuses? Or what? Did you guys come up with this idea?
So Casey was actually the person that came up with this idea. Last quarter, actually, Casey was telling us about his like idea to do this, and he started the project, but when they like changed up the layout of gold, it kind of messed up the entire project, so then he had to start from scratch. And it wasn't until that SB Hackathon that he brought it up to us to say, hey, let's pick it up and get running again. So
that's awesome. So I remember we were talking earlier that on Sunday, how many users did it have when it first came out?
So Sunday I just made a developer account, and I posted it up, and I think Adrian mentioned to a few friends, so did Natasha, and we got 32 users the first day, and then Monday we got 1,500 more, and then Tuesday we got 475 more, and then yesterday we have 275 more. So we're at 2,100 users right now, or 2,400 users right now.
Dang, that is incredible. What do you think you have to attribute, or what? Why do you think they grew so fast?
I think it was a combination of just taking all of our talents together to create something really great, just making really useful design, very clear, having a really good back end, making it really functional, and then also just Adrian posting it up on the Freedom for Sale page for UCSB, and on Monday the likes on it just grew so much faster than we had ever expected it to, and everyone was talking about it and news spread really fast, so I think that really helped us.
That's awesome. So what do you think the next step is for this app? Do you have a next step, or is it kind of done?
Well, it's been interesting. We've been listening to some user feedback. They wanted to see the number of ratings for each professor, and we added that, pushed that out last night. And then we've actually had two people contribute to our repository on GitHub. It's really odd. One kid actually ported it to Safari, so now it's a Safari extension too.
Whoa.
Yeah.
And then our TA from last quarter actually brought in grade distribution statistics from myedu.com.
So now there's going to be like a little graph that shows all the different grade distributions for
that professor for that course.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think people got excited about it and really just wanted to start contributing the little bits that they could. So I think it's going to have an opportunity to expand a lot more.
That's amazing. Are you guys going to try to spread this to other campuses?
To do that, we need logins to see what their course registration looks like. The backside of it can be the same, getting the ratings, putting a pop-up in.
Right.
We have to know where to get the professor names.
Right.
So we could do it. We have friends in the schools, and we might do it later on.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, so you said this was part of the UCSB hackathon, right?
Yes.
So what is the actual technical stuff that went into this? How much work did you actually have to put in?
So the entire duration of the hackathon was 36 hours. But I think we might have ended up putting maybe 12, a little bit more than 12 hours actually into it.
20 hours, I'd say.
20 hours?
More like
we worked
20.
Friday night, so yeah.
Actually, yeah, that sounds about right. Yeah, around 20 hours of like actual sitting down and coding it. The first night we got there, I think it was like 6, maybe 7 o'clock.
Sometime.
And then we went all the way up until like 5 a.m. that first night. And then at 5 a.m. we were just completely dead. So, we went back to sleep, went to our houses and slept, and then came back the next day around the same time, just like around 4 maybe, and then finished at 8 o'clock that day. So,
So is that the kind of usual thing for making these kind of apps, is you just don't sleep at all and just work until it's done?
Well, when you're on a roll, you definitely have the motivation to just keep going even if you're like really tired. So
it definitely depends on the environment, because when you're in a hackathon, everyone is just sitting there working, very zoned into their work. And we put aside time for the whole entire weekend so that we would be able to actually do this, even though we had other coursework to do, other projects that were coming up. But it was really nice to just be able to sit in a room where everyone was really into what they were doing, and it made it a lot easier to just put in the time, sit there for hours without really complaining about it, and just get what we needed to do done.
That's awesome. And what has been UCSB's reaction to that?
So far, the students have loved it. They've given a couple, points of feedback, but we're listening to them. And then Yeah, I haven't heard from the school at all yet, any administration or anything.
Oh yeah, no reaction from the professor?
Yeah, right? nothing negative.
Because I'm interested if that's like, if they're stoked that it's so much easier now, if they're going to be, the professors are going
to... I'd say we're definitely interested also to see what the school thinks, yeah. So
yeah. We'll see how they react to it. If they don't, that's fine also. I mean, I hope it's a positive, I hope it's a positive thing,
right.
You know?
Right.
If they like it and they... like those students working hard to build something.
Right, absolutely.
Building their resumes.
Yeah, and so to get this app, you said it's on Google Chrome and it's on Safari.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And how do you add the plugin for either one?
You basically go to the Chrome extension store, and now we're in the search database, so you can just search the name of the extension, Rate My Gold, and then it should just pop up straight away. And there'll be a little button in the corner that says add extension, you add it, and then it'll just automatically start working on just the course listing page.
Yeah.
And then
okay.
You can disable it and enable it whenever you want to, so.
Wow.
Yeah, I want to state that this extension is only request permissions for just that course page. So it only becomes, our script only becomes active when you are on the course listing page, not on any other page in Gold.
Right.
And
so
your data isn't taken and put anywhere else. All we get is the professor names and put them in the professors to get the ratings.
Yeah, we had a question come up earlier about security
issues.
Yeah. And we explained to the person that there's nothing going on that's related to your actual account. It's basically, if you want to think of it as like an overlay, it just happens when you're on that actual site. It doesn't see who you are. It doesn't see what kind of things are on your actual account.
Gotcha.
It just allows you to click that button whenever you're on the certain course listings page, and that's it. So there's no security issues with it.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's so cool. I can't wait to get home and actually download this.
Thanks, man. Check it out, definitely.
That's fantastic. So I guess my last question would be, do you think this is something that the university might ever purchase to make as an actual like built-in function of their website?
That would be so cool.
We were actually talking about that yesterday, the possibility of it, but I don't know. We'll have to see.
Yeah,
I doubt that they would actually want to purchase it. You know, if they asked for it and we could help support it, then we would, you know.
Yeah.
We're looking more just to kind of build our resumes and help USSB students than actually get money off of this.
Yeah.
So
the plan was always just a project for fun that we could all do and complete over the weekend, and everything else is just kind of the icing on top of the cake.
Yeah.
That's
and
awesome.
All three of us like totally decided we don't want to charge students for this. This is something that we should all like,
yeah, we just want
help
to
out
the
other
train.
Students.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
Well, we got your back.
That's
awesome. That's awesome. Well, thank you guys so much for coming out, and best of luck furthering the app and everything.
Thanks for having us.
And
yeah,
thanks
for
again
having
for giving
us
all such a great tool.
Yeah,
I can't.
Thank you.
Of course.
Yeah.
All right.